Welcome to Bring It Gaming UK presents the Unashamed Gamers, episode 28.
Normally we'd do like a cheesy joke at the start, but I mean the only thing I can think to say is that Call of Duty Infinite Warfare is out now for full price. 3, 2, 1, fight! Welcome back to the Unashamed Gamers with Ben and Paul. Today we're going to be talking about the Nintendo Switch, which is the new console Nintendo have just announced. Well, not just announced, but recently announced.
Yeah, I'm excited. Switch. Switch. What is it?
Switch.
Nobody cares.
Switch.
Nobody cares, apart from China and Japan, and you're welcome to it. Thanks for listening.
It's just... it was like anything, like when you see a trailer... There's a part of you like you jump on a bandwagon straight away. I was like, well, that looks quite cool. And then the more I thought about it, I'm like, nah. Upon closer reflection, I mean, anyone who doesn't know, the console is it's handheld. It goes on a docking station. It looks like an iPad, but the controls are either side of it, and they can be removed.
Yeah.
And then people can pass a control to a friend. They can both play it because the iPad basically, the iPad will stand up on its side so they can play it.
Yeah.
But I mean, I don't know if you've looked at the Wii U remote.
Yeah.
If you actually look at the Wii U remote and then you look at them side by side,
yeah.
It's like they've just cut the sides off the Wii U remote.
Yeah.
And made them slot on and off.
To me, the appeal of it is that you can play in your home, and then you can take it from your home to on the bus to work or at the park with your friends. No gamer wants to sit in a park and play video games.
Yeah.
Someone says to me, oh, it's a nice day, so I'll open a window while I play video games. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
It's personal preference. But I mean, and obviously I can only comment, I mean, obviously we are Brick Game UK, so obviously our opinions are going to be based on that. But in the UK, outside of maybe probably London and maybe the middle of, like, say, maybe Manchester.
Yeah.
Outside of that, you don't really get many people playing, like, expensive shit on public transport.
No, definitely
because
not.
There's not as well out of this.
We would have the Nintendo Switch.
I wouldn't have an iPad out. I'm 6'1", tired, bearded, and I'm happy to punch someone if they get too leery. Like, I'm not going to... I stand up for myself. That's all I'm saying. I'm not, like, kind of looking for trouble. I'm not, but you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah.
I'd stand up for myself, you know what I mean? I'd stand up for people I care about, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
I'm not scared to be outside or anything like that.
Yeah.
But even I wouldn't sit on public transport with an iPad, and not because that's not something I'm personally interested in.
Yeah.
But just because in my mind, I'm like, I'm going to have a £300 of equipment on my lap when anyone could just come over and yark it out my hand.
Yeah. I mean, he'd stand up for himself, but he wouldn't come for his best friend in a zombie apocalypse.
You're still bitter about
that. I'm telling them.
I'm telling them. You're telling on us to our three listeners.
I'm telling on you to our four listeners. My mom listens as well. Hypothetically, we're talking about a zombie apocalypse. And Ben, I said, you know, as long as you come for me, that would be fine. He was talking about, you know, how to survive. And he said, mate, I wouldn't come for you. He said it. And yeah, you actually meant it, and I'm
of course
hurt.
I'm
he's 6'1", he's bearded, he's tattooed, and he's standing up for himself, but he wouldn't come for his best mate in the zombie apocalypse.
Mate, it's just too out of the way.
Yeah,
you know, I mean, and I've got to get to that Asda and, you know, like,
I know.
Get the trucks parked in front of the doors. And
yeah, let's just make the podcast about a zombie apocalypse. But no, in all seriousness, the Switch, there is people who are going to play it, and that's fine. I mean, to me, the Nintendo... It's the kids' console.
Yeah,
that's the way I look at it.
That's the thing. That's my point about, like, you know, the adverts show, like, you know, young adults using it in public and stuff, and I'm just like, that isn't gonna happen.
No,
Nintendo.
It's not.
Like, that
it's
isn't.
Not. Especially just, in our
just
area.
Show kids playing it, because then if you show loads of kids playing it,
the kids are gonna want it for Christmas.
Then the kids are gonna want it for Christmas, and the parents will buy it for the kids, because if they see their kids, they're like, oh, look, that'll make like. Kid not talk to us for a day. That's brilliant. I'll buy it right now.
Sold.
Yeah, I'll take four.
Yeah, I'll take nine. And
I'll take one to every appendage.
Yeah.
Just, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah. Well, to me, I thought, oh, this is a bit meh. And then I saw them playing Skyrim on the Switch. And I thought, well, if that's Skyrim remastered, it's obviously going to be, you know, it's going to be decent.
Enough,
but then Bethesda turned around and said, well, you know, we don't know if it's going to play on the Switch.
Yeah.
So they just use a clip of a game,
a clip,
put it in, and be like, well, you might be able to play
this.
They're
basically saying, on this iPad, you can watch Twitch.
Yeah, exactly. And that's, to me, an iPad, you can only get a certain amount of games that look okay.
Yeah.
And I think they're going to be behind again. They're marking it again the wrong way. If I love Nintendo as a kid. Mario was the first game I ever played. Duck Hunt being the second.
Yeah.
And that was on the NES. And I loved Mario and Nintendo then. And I loved it in the SNES days and stuff like that. And then obviously I moved on to Sega and then from to PlayStation. Sega had the right idea. They've stopped making consoles and they've started to make games for other consoles. And Nintendo need to do that. Yeah. I'm not hyped at all for the Switch. As soon as I saw you could take it outside, I thought, well, there you go. You've killed it for me.
For me, I think it's a case of, you know, obviously we're not the casual gamer.
No.
But I still don't think they're catering great to the casual gamer either.
No, not at all.
The thing is they're catering to... You basically, unless you're a Nintendo fan, it's not good for you. Like, I loved Nintendo growing up. Like, Nintendo was my formative years of playing games. You know, definitely. I love Mario, and I would still happily play any Mario game ever.
Uh-huh.
But I'm not going to pay £300 to play Mario.
That's it.
Do you know what I mean?
Exactly
but,
that.
But obviously, it's speculation. We don't know at this point. But, you know, the past few console generations... their console generations anyway, have shown that they haven't had great third-party support, and that's what they need. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
If you told me, like, there's going to be, like, good shooters on it, because I like my shooters. Yeah. If you told me you can put... Oh, even if it, like, it wasn't, say, the latest one, you know, like, if you could say you can play at least the equivalent graphically of, say, Battlefield 3.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, two Battlefields ago, right? But no, but listen to this, like, that's two Battlefields ago, but, you know, if I could play a shooter that good on it...
Uh-huh.
But I don't want to play Battlefield 3, you know what I mean? I just want to play one that, you know, at least looks and plays as good as Battlefield 3.
Right, okay.
If I could play that in bed, then I'd be quite happy with it. Like, that would kind of, you might win us with that, you know what I mean? Because, I mean, I know if you could play Battlefield 3, then you can play pretty much any COD, because they all look the same.
Yeah.
You know what I mean, though? But, like, you know, if you need that, I don't know, the good games in terms of, you know, third-party developers, Nintendo don't make great... shooters.
No, they don't make great apart from Mario.
They kind of make Mario and Zelda.
Zelda, yeah.
Which, you know, they are brilliant. They are. I haven't got a bad word to say about either series, you know what I mean? Mario and Zelda are absolutely brilliant, but I just don't know if that holds a console up.
Yeah, well, that's it. That's pretty much what sells their consoles is the Mario and Zelda games.
And the big thing, I mean, the other two consoles have is they're media centres as well.
Yeah, yeah. And
like, your whole family uses them, not just for gaming.
Yeah. I mean, I got the Wii, Nintendo Wii, and that was it for me. It looked terrible. I had an Xbox 360 and I got a Wii, and I just thought, well, what's Nintendo doing? They needed, personally, I know it sounds horrible, but they should start making the consoles and they should start selling the games to
others. I'd have to disagree with you on the Wii front, because I think Wii was brilliant.
I hated the Wii.
Because the Wii was intentionally bad. Like, the new wasn't good looking.
Yeah.
But it was the charm, and it was the, you know, you've got the nunchucks and the... That's what made it fun.
Yeah.
I know, obviously, you're not upset, but the numbers don't lie. Like, was probably the most successful console in about 15, 20 years.
Yeah.
Like, that did hugely well. And the failed on the Wii U. The Wii U just didn't...
Right. Well, I didn't get the Wii U.
Nobody got the Wii U. Like, I mean, numbers.
I mean, they marketed really that Wii U game, Wii U console with a zombie game, Zombie U, and it still didn't appeal. Yeah. It was because it was the looking down away from the screen, and there was another screen on the remote or whatever it was.
I mean, at one point, I think it was like you could snipe someone, so the actual aiming reticle was on the screen.
No. It was just like, I want to be able to come in from a stressful day, sit down with a controller in my hand, and shoot someone in the face. Yeah.
That's why I'm saying, like, you could get us in if it was a case of, like, I've got this console and I can play quite at least playable, decent shooter. Mm-hmm. If I can play something like that, then that might be all right, because then in theory I could be sat next to my girlfriend, she's watching TV, and I'm playing with the headphones in, I'm sat next to her. You know what I mean? Rather than having to skulk off to my gaming cave, you know what I mean?
Yeah, which is awesome, by the way.
But you know what I mean, though?
Yeah.
So that you might swing some people with that, but that's the only way you're going to get a lot of people, I think. I think otherwise you're only going to get the hardcore Nintendo fans, and I don't know if that's enough to keep your console alive for a cycle.
That's it. That's what I think they're doing again, they're catering. I mean, I totally disagree with what you're saying, because I love gaming, you love gaming. All we do is game. And what for me is that... I don't want to take a game console outside with us. I am happy enough to game for 6 hours, go out and do something and come back.
Yeah.
I don't need to go out and still game. Yeah. Whereas these casuals or the Nintendo Elite or whatever they want to call themselves, they are happy to do that. But in Britain, and especially in our area, you take something that's a lot of money on the bus, you're going to get it taken away from you. And that's not because we can't defend ourselves or anything. It's because people are horrible. And if they see something of value, they will beat you down and take it from you. And that...
They would. I'm not going to say that's 100% going to happen, but...
No, obviously not.
But it's also like... I don't know if it's a UK or like maybe even a European thing, but I would feel dead awkward, like people watching us over there. Yeah. I like that anonymity of gaming.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And like just doing my own thing. But like, I wouldn't like, you know, the person, I mean, I already feel like if I sit on the bus, the stinky person finds us.
Oh, they do,
sits next to us too close anyway. Well, now they're going to lean over and they're going to be like, oh, that's a Switch. Passes a controller. So
yeah. Let me put my stinky hands on it. Yeah.
Yeah.
And they would, because some people are like that.
Yeah.
And even when you read a paper on the bus, people will lean over and read it over your shoulder. Yeah. And I just think, you know, I'd never take a laptop on a bus.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'll take my phone because I can put it away. If someone shady comes on the bus and I think, well, they're going to try and nick me phone. Not that anyone would.
I think the only time you can do it on a bus is like a coach. Like if you're on a coach trip there,
it's acceptable.
That's kind of a given, but like just regular public transport.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, in the Northeast, there's like a train service called the Metro.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's literally like, I don't think it's been cleaned since the 70s.
No, it's the worst.
There's dead bodies on it, everything. Yeah. Not really, but you know, it's
might as well be.
There might as well be.
It smells like, no, but the Metro is pretty much worse than the bus, because anyone gets on the Metro, you've got to pay for the bus. So you've got to at least have money to get on the bus. Whereas the Metro, you can walk on.
You can walk on, yeah.
Yes.
Unless there's someone there to check for it, then...
Yeah, exactly. So you're going to get your waifs and strays who think, oh, well, I'll steal this Nintendo Switch from this person. I'll be sat with my headphones on.
And still someone comes over and talks to you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. Because people are the worst.
Headphones in.
Yeah. I don't want to talk to you. Yeah. Headphones in.
Can you just imagine?
No, but what's the time though, mate?
Can you just imagine some smackhead trying to ask him what it is?
Yeah.
What's that? Can I sell it for more heroin? What?
Can I have a go? And you're like,
no, exactly.
No, didn't be stingy, man.
It's the awkwardness of other people looking in at you. Yeah. And it's the awkwardness of the like someone staring at you like, well, shall I steal that off them?
Yeah.
Because people, unfortunately, like that.
On the flip side, like what I was saying,
there's no flip side.
No, there is. And I don't... This is what I don't understand, or you don't see, is that it is great for kids.
Yeah.
It is 100% great for kids. Obviously, you don't drive yet. But when you drive, you already pop a phone in front of your kid. There's your phone case. You play on your phone. Play a game on your phone. It's going to be like that. It'd be great in the backseat of the car. But that's my problem with the advert so far, is you're saying like... You're showing us a picture of like mid-20s people
in the park.
In the park hanging out, or like
if you're in your 20s in the park, you're
that neighbour who happens to live, you know, just across the street is having a roof party. Fuck off, America.
Yeah, nah.
And then
that
like,
doesn't happen.
Come on over, guys. And she's like, she doesn't stop playing for a second. She just switches it from the fucking screen to the portable. Because that's the thing, if you put it in the docking station, you can play it normal on a console. And the controller that had looked very Xbox, which is a good design choice, because it's... I'm not even a fanboy of Xbox at all.
Yeah.
But Xbox has a much better controller.
Yeah, they do, yeah.
It does. But I still love my PlayStation, but the controller is just way better.
I just...
And it looked very... And that's fine, you know what I mean? But to get us to have a prime position between the two...
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We've got the Xbox One and the PS4. For me to put a Switch in the centre, it needs to... The third-party games need to be great, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I need to have... Like other, not necessarily third party games, because I mean, if it's a case of like, you know, Call of Duty's on all the consoles, you're never gonna pick it for the Switch because it's probably gonna be the least powerful version. So it's gonna have to have unique games, really good games.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that does sound in the back of the car. That's fine, but again, the way the advert played out was you were a 20-year-old who was sat in a park and you were playing a versus game or whatever it was with your friend, and that's just sucky.
Is like, say, like, obviously shooters, how are you going to play it online?
Exactly.
On traveling, what you use, you're going to tether it to your phone and use all your data.
Yeah. I mean, for me, I like to sit down and game, and it would probably be okay if it was just that, but the fact that you can't switch it, and as an adult, I don't want to do that. I don't want to take it out of the house. I mean, it's good for kids, that's fine, but why market a console for kids? Market a console for everyone. Kids play all sorts of games, and unfortunately, they play games like Call of Duty and Battlefield. But that play all sorts of games. So if it is a kid's console, market it for that. Yeah. But you're not. You're marketing it for 20-somethings who sit in a park.
Yeah.
Who does that? Especially in Britain. Who sits in a park and plays a video game?
I want to get like 1 week of sun a year.
Yeah, exactly.
And we all go sit in a park in that week, don't get us wrong.
Yeah.
But that doesn't warrant a £300 console.
It doesn't.
That's, I mean, we're speculating on price, but I mean, I can't imagine it's going to be... It's not gonna be more expensive than the current consoles.
No, I don't think so.
It's not gonna be drastically cheaper than them. No. So I'm gonna say it's gonna fall between £200 and £400.
Yeah.
In the UK.
And you'll get a Mario game with it. I mean, don't get us wrong, I love Mario.
Yeah, I love Mario. I love to play more Mario, but
I would rather play it on an Xbox or a PlayStation 4 though.
Yeah. Just yeah.
Like that's personally that's my problem. Is Sega realized that. And Sega have went on to make some good games. The Alien Isolation is the best game I've played from Sega in a long, long time.
Yeah.
And I think Nintendo would make a lot more money. The newest game for Mario is Mario 3D Maker or something it's called. Something along the lines of that.
Mario Maker.
Yeah, Mario Maker. And you get to create your own levels and upload them.
That was the one game that everyone universally said worked well on Wii U because of the touchscreen. You could literally just drag the things you want.
Yeah, exactly.
And you'd be able to do that again because the Switch has got the exact same peripheral, basically. So that would work. Mario Maker will translate perfectly to that console. But that's not the problem. Like I say, the Mario games are going to work perfectly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And we don't doubt that for a second.
No, definitely not.
It's just like you say, it's the other things. Like, what Nintendo need to do is they need a proper whammy. They need some game that really separates them. And like I say, for me, like I say, and I think a lot of, like I say, 20-somethings are like, oh, no, I'm not a 20-something, I'm 30.
I know.
You know what I mean? But I mean, the average game is 34, so something.
Yeah. So, yeah, do that.
No, but like, what they need is a really good shooter on it to pull that in. And the only thing I can think of is like maybe like another Perfect Dark.
Yeah.
Something like that, but like really good.
Yeah. I mean, to me,
a company like Rare to make a really good game for them, but like make it exclusive for their console and make it run really good, and then like that might make us, because I'd be like, oh, that's the only place I can play that. Then yeah, I might.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it worked for me with the Xbox. You know what I mean? I bought Dead Rising because I bought an Xbox because of Dead Rising.
Yeah.
And again, I bought the Xbox One because of Dead Rising 3. And I suppose that would work. But again, it's the thing that annoys me the most about it. It's that, and every time I've seen the trailer, I've watched it about 4 times, is the fact that you can just pick it up like an iPad and take it out. iPads do not have the best frame rate resolution and stuff like that. And is that what it is? Is that all it is? It's just a Nintendo's version of an iPad and we're going to get games in 720p. And not that I'm a graphics whore. It's just...
You're a graphics whore, yeah.
But we're already at a place now where we're moving on to 4K, and Nintendo are still 4 years now behind, and that's my problem.
That's where the only way they can stand out is through like exclusives or like some extreme innovation.
Because
they're not going to win on a power or graphical front. No. So they need to blow your mind with something else.
I mean, Pokemon.
Splatoon.
Yeah, I think Pokemon. There'll be a Pokemon game because Pokemon Go, although it only lasted a friggin' couple of months. Was massive.
What does it have a camera on? I can't remember.
I don't know.
I don't remember noticing it. I imagine it will have some sort of camera on it. Right. On one side.
But I think there'll be a Pokemon game like the Pokemon Red and the Silver.
Yeah.
And I like those games. And it may tempt us, not first, like, day one.
Yeah.
But it may tempt us to buy it because my kids both love Pokemon as well.
Like I say, that's the only thing I can think of.
But it would have to be mind-blowing. Like,
market it towards children and then,
Yeah. If it was marketed towards kids, my Lily, she's 5, my Lily would say, oh, I want that, Dad. And that would have probably swung it for me, like, because I like my kids to game because I'm a gamer myself. And that would have probably swung it for me.
Yeah.
But again, it's the 20-somethings in a park or at a house party playing video games. If you're at a house party, you're getting drunk. Yeah. You're having a laugh. You're trying to hit on someone who's like a 10 and you're a 4. That's personal. That's personal experience. Do you know what I mean? I'm the 4, unfortunately. I'm not the 10, I wish. But seriously, do you know what I mean? You're not playing a video game. Because if you are, you're not at a party because you're in the house. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. It's true though. It is true that, like, you know what I mean? It's even like that they'll have like a roof party, but I mean the equivalent's like a barbecue. You don't go to a barbecue
with a video game
and ignore everyone and play it. And the fact that, you know, two players is great. Like, I don't, that's kind of neat.
Yeah.
Like, kind of. You know what I mean? Where it's like, oh yeah, you can both slot controller off each side and then you can both play Mario Kart. They will play Mario Kart. But there was like two of them were playing Mario Kart and like three other people watching them. So yeah. So the three other people bored.
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah.
So like,
I love Mario Kart. Love it. Love it. Love it. Donkey Kong. I love that. But again, to me, release those games. You know, if there was a remastered collection of those games, or not even remastered, they just gently upscaled them a little bit, and you could play them on the Xbox One, I'd pay 60 quid for Mario, Yoshi's Island, for Donkey Kong, Mario Kart.
That the mini NES that they announced?
Yeah.
That's selling really well.
Yeah, I want that.
That's just a tiny original Nintendo
lookalike,
and it's got 60 inbuilt games, and it's, what, 50 quid?
Yeah.
And that's selling insanely well, which just shows you the market is there.
It's just, again, that I would prefer to buy that, even if it was, it had every game from NES, it had every single
Sega
game
did it on
for 400 quid.
I think it was called the Sega Collection or something.
Yeah.
And that sold really well.
Yeah, exactly.
And
because
Sega
people
have done
want
the right
games.
Thing there. Yeah, people do still, like you say, that's what I'm saying. Mario will be around for the rest of time. Like,
oh, will, definitely.
They'll never lose out on Mario. It's just, that's the thing, though, is where a lot of Nintendo sales come from is the 3DS is hugely popular.
Yeah.
Because it's hugely popular among kids.
Again,
it's hugely popular in
the market
Japan and things like that. Mm-hmm. But yeah, just admit what your target is. Your target is children.
Yeah.
But the thing is the show with Skyrim, and Skyrim is not children.
No, it's not. No.
Skyrim is hugely targeted towards adults.
Yeah.
It's a mature game. So you're showing Skyrim, and you're getting us, like, you know, hardcore gamers, you're getting us, like, interest. We're like, why?
Yeah.
Good enough to play Skyrim. And then you're like, nah, we're just showing that because, like, for example,
that's the
problem.
Yeah.
The biggest problem is right now, it's for example, it's like, until they come in with hard facts of, he has this third-party publisher that said they're definitely going to make a game.
Exactly.
Until we get those facts right now, there's not much reason to buy it.
Yeah.
Unless you're looking for that classic Nintendo fix, you know what I mean? If you want a new Donkey Kong and you want
a new... I mean...
And there's not wrong with that, but I just don't know there's many people...
Yeah. I mean, like, for me, they did market it wrong. If it had been, like I said, if it had been just kids in the trailer and they were playing at little kids' parties and stuff, that would have been fine because then we'd know where we stood as consumers. We'd know, well, this is a child's console. This is something that the kids can play in the back of the car or the park.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why they played at the park because they should be playing in the park. Do you know what I mean? They're outside.
Yeah.
But, and I do kind of understand it because most 10 to 19-year-olds, they're all obsessed with their phones now.
Yeah.
That's all they do is look at their phones. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's cool. But again, it was the adults you were shown to be playing the game. If it had been marketed as a kid's console and you just showed kids games, like the Mario games and stuff, that could have been a day one buy for me. But because they showed these adults at parties playing video games, it just makes me think, well, that's not what real gamers do.
It makes us think they have no idea what they're doing. It makes
Casual gamers that don't take video games out.
Yeah.
They sit, even if the casual gamers who play for like 3 hours a week, they'll sit and play an hour a day on that TV in the house.
I can think of, easily off the top of my head, I can probably think of 15 people I know personally who buy 5 games a year. And I would call them casual gamers.
Yeah.
Because they'll only buy, you know, the big releases.
Yeah.
But they drop serious money, you know what I mean? Like, when a new console comes out, they'll buy a new
console. They'll buy the console,
And then, like you say, over the course of a year, they'll probably spend £200 to £300 on games.
Mm. I spent that last month.
Do you know what I mean?
I didn't, but yeah. Yeah, I mean, like, my mate Paul's a casual gamer. He buys FIFA and a Gears of War game now and again.
Yeah.
And that's what I see as a casual gamer. He'll play one game every year.
Yeah.
And that it doesn't appeal to him either because, again, he doesn't want to go out to play FIFA. He wants to sit in his house. Like, after a long day at work, he wants to come home and play FIFA. Do you know what I mean? So it's marketed totally wrong.
I understand the comfort of the home thing, but they need to make it, like I say, more practical. Like, you know what I mean? Like I say, sitting in the living room playing. So, like, oh, you're free to watch stuff on the TV.
Yeah.
And I'm not neglecting you by being in a completely different part of the house. Like, you know what I mean? Like, that makes sense.
Yeah, it does, yeah.
But not like, oh, I'm switching now because I'm leaving the house and I'm going to go sit on my friend's roof.
Yeah, but exactly. But to me, even that, it sounds annoying because, like, I'm getting older. I need to wear glasses to play video games. Do you know what I mean? Like,
I didn't know that.
Yeah, well, I do. Like, I don't have them, but I do need them. Like, to read stuff, I'm, like, squinting.
Yeah.
So on this tiny screen, I'm going to be like, well, what does that say? What's my objective? So I'm going to be looking at the screen thinking, well, I'm even more annoyed than I normally am.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So It doesn't appeal to me at all, I'm going to be honest. I mean, we're always better in this podcast, but to me,
yeah,
I mean, it's not COD, so that's great. But again, it's just, it does not appeal to me at all.
COD, you know what I mean? I mean, that's the thing as well, is we haven't obviously had like hard facts as yet. And we kind of need to know price, specs.
Yeah.
But most importantly, we need to know content. Like, what can we play on this game?
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, what
other than Mario.
And what outside of, like you say, the staple titles, like, what will I want to play?
Yeah, exactly.
Because that's the thing, is like you say, is, I loved Mario as a kid, and I can't hate Mario because he'll always hold a special place in my heart because of those memories.
Yeah, for those memories as a child.
And those memories of like playing with my gran as a kid and things like that. Like, I loved that, and she loved it, and it was a bonding experience for us.
Yeah.
And it was one of the first games. But the thing is like, you know, it's like anything, controllers have evolved, and so have gamers, you know what I mean? Like, my reaction times are insanely fast compared to what they were as a kid, you know what I mean? Like, half the time, like, I couldn't jump over two Goombas. You know what I mean? Like, I never completed I never completed Mario. Like, I could get to the last level with one life.
So yeah.
And it was the pressure of one life was too much for us. It's like a 5-year-old, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then by the time I was ready, probably good enough to complete it, I'd moved on to Super Nintendo.
Yeah.
So in Super Nintendo, I started completing Mario games then. But, like, I never actually completed that, and I've just never went back and played it just because I've just always moved forward. But it's just like that, like, I don't think right now a Mario game would probably hold my attention.
Yeah.
Like, I would probably play it for the nostalgia fact. I probably wouldn't complete it because I'd probably get bored before I got that far.
The first Nintendo Mario game I completed was Super Mario Bros. 3.
Yeah.
Loved that. I played it loads and loads and loads.
Yeah.
But to me, we're talking about the games and stuff like that. Other than the Marios, the Donkey Kongs, and the Zelda games, could you think of a game that you played on a Nintendo?
I can think of games that I played, but...
Yeah, but, like, that... Do you know what I mean? That you could go back for, be like, oh, well, this is... Oh, well, they're remaking this, or they're doing a sequel of this.
Only GoldenEye. And GoldenEye will never get an official sequel, because it's, like, wrapped up in litigation. So,
what... Unless they've got some game coming that's going to blow us away...
That's what I'm saying. They need something insane.
And I don't think they've got it. I think...
They need something either insane or so unique that the fact that it's exclusive makes it a must have.
I mean, I'm
sure, like you say, if Skyrim does run on it and it runs perfectly, it's still not going to be my choice console because I've already got a PlayStation 4 and an Xbox One that will both run Skyrim.
It needs an exclusive that is, and I mean,
and it
I
needs
think
more than one, one isn't enough.
I know, but like the one exclusive, do you know how like Dead Rising was
it needs a great launch.
I think they could possibly do that with a Pokemon game, but it can't be the Pokemon games from the handheld consoles. It has to be something new. I played Pokemon Stadium and it was terrible.
Yeah,
I hated that, but I want,
I don't think you've had, like, there hasn't really been a Pokemon game with amazing graphics.
I want that's what I want. I want it to play where the world is open world.
Imagine a Pokemon game that looked like Witcher.
Yeah, exactly. That's it. That's your exclusive right there, Nintendo Switch. A Pokemon game that looked like The Witcher, and you battle Pokemon, you capture them. The basics of the game stay the same, but it looks like that.
Using the online infrastructure that we have now, so you can play versus
Pokemon battles. Do you know what it is? If that's what they've got, I'd buy the Switch tomorrow.
Yeah.
If they've got online Pokemon battles, it looks like The Witcher, and it's like a 30-hour campaign, and you've got to battle loads, and you can... That I'm sold. Like, I'm genuinely goosebumps.
Even if it's like... It doesn't have to look photorealistic. Because that doesn't write in the world.
No.
But, you know, if it's cel-shaded, third-person, open world...
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And it's not like you're running on the side kind of thing. Kind of like... Even if it... Grand Theft Auto 3-esque, do you know what I mean? Like,
or
that...
Like cel-shaded or something.
Yeah, but it looks better, yeah? Like, the graphics are better. I would be happy with that.
Mm-hmm.
What's that game with the zombies... And you skate along rails and stuff like that.
Oh,
totally forgot that game. That game.
Oh, Sunset Overdrive.
Sunset Overdrive. If it has that kind of
that
look,
that would work really well.
That would blow my mind.
Imagine that.
If I could
customize a trainer, so it could be male or female.
Yeah.
Customize to a certain extent.
Buy clothes for them.
And then just the staple stuff from the Game Boy games. So, you know, naming your Pokemon. And
yeah, exactly.
Literally, you walk along and then the music plays. Or,
and you've got a battle. Yeah.
And one pops
up. It looks good. And the battle isn't just them making a noise or something. And it looks realistic.
But imagine that, though. Imagine being able to, you know, maybe squad up with two or three people And then you just go and take on another school or,
yeah, like that,
or another group of people that would be...
Right now, you're doing Nintendo's job for them because that's making me want to buy the Switch.
Yeah.
That whole trailer, I was like, nah. The 2-minute pitch we've just made up of a Pokemon game, I want to buy that. Yeah. I want that game.
Yeah, that would be... That's the thing, though. That would get in, like, say, a lot of...
Yeah.
Obviously, the casuals, your biggest market, that would get your casuals 100%.
Yeah.
But you would also pull a lot of people who, like, you know... Like, I'm totally on the fence right now. Like, I'm not going to say no on the Switch. Like, I'm going to be open-minded and say, you know, maybe.
Uh-huh.
But it's going to have to blow us away.
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't, like, I say, I think the original Wii showed, obviously not for you, your graphics hole. but the original Wii showed, you know, like, that graphics aren't everything as long as the content's worth playing, like, mm-hmm. there's enough worth playing, or there's something at least interesting enough. And... I think that's what they need to do. It doesn't have to be the best looking, but
yeah.
It kind of at least has to be 360 graphics.
To me, my problem is, it's not the graphics, it's the standing up with the nunchucks and stuff like that. I played Resident Evil 4 first on the Wii, and I completed it 100 times on the Wii. I love that game, but it was the aiming with the nunchucks. I just don't like it.
That's why I'm not interested in VR.
Exactly. Oh, my God.
I'm not interested in that looking about and moving. And I know it sounds lazy, but I do. It's a relaxing thing for a lot of people. Gaming is my, like, come down. You know, like, other people go read a book or sit and watch TV. Like, the binge watch Netflix. Mine's sitting down and playing games.
Yeah.
But it's sitting down.
Sitting down, not playing games. Yeah, I mean,
it's not, you know, running on a virtual treadmill. And
yeah, I've heard people are actually vomiting because of VR. Like, because it's so, like, realistic or something. It does something to our brain. Like, not realistic, but do you know what I mean? And, again, it's just something I don't want.
The thing with VR right now, though, is, for me personally, it's not just the VR thing. I like, because I would get it in terms of something that I wouldn't play all the time, but I'll play it now and again. Like a light gun game.
Yeah.
Because I enjoy light gun games when I go to an arcade. But, like, obviously I wouldn't play it every day. But in the past, like on my PlayStation 2, I had a light gun.
Yeah.
I played light gun games. And I'm happy with it in that sense. But right now, it just feels like you're visiting an arcade.
It's the next Kinect for me, personally.
I think... Maybe in 5 to 10 years' time, there might be something really worth playing right now.
Yeah.
Everything feels really superficial right now.
Yeah. Even the Batman game where you get to be Batman, really, that's how they're selling it.
It looks
You put your arm out, and it's not even a full arm, it's just a glove. It's the glove, and you throw a batarang, and I'm just, that's not Batman.
Yeah.
And it shows you your face in a Batman mask.
Yeah.
I don't want to see my face in a Batman mask. I see my face. Do you know what I mean?
Well, you can on the new show is coming next week.
You can, and you'll be like, wow, that's actual human.
Sadly. Oh my God, what are you? I think we're going to play a trailer at the end of this episode.
Yes, we are, actually, So, if you've listened this far, well done. First of all, well done. And you'll get to see our faces, for our new show, Where Next, which is coming... Where is it coming next, Ben?
Next week.
Whoa, look at that. We've got jokes.
Get out. But yeah, I mean, I think in summation, not hyped for Switch.
Nah, not at all.
I'm not saying never.
I know you're saying never.
But I'm not gonna say never right now. But
yeah, but never.
That's all. It's gonna be never.
Yeah. If they make the game that Wii U just created.
How I felt when Wii U happened. The Wii U was the same. I was sat there. I'm going like, but. Who wants it?
Yeah, nobody wants
and
this.
And the thing
Nintendo.
Is, the numbers, I think they sold like 4 million, which is on paper is amazing, but in terms of console sales, it's crap.
It was like... But yeah, I mean, if they make the Pokemon game that we've just made up, obviously they're listening, Nintendo, they're listening. Listen, Nintendo. Seriously, listen. Make that game.
Two guys in a box room in Ashton, and we know, man.
We know our shit. Yeah. Make that game. You've got a sale right there. I'll get my friends to buy it so I can beat them with my Charmander. Because
like a mouse. That's the thing.
And that's not a sexual thing.
It would be. I mean, like you say, I'm sure you could fight on the Game Boys where you did the Link play.
Yeah.
Put them together.
But it just.
But that's what I'm saying. That was good enough then because it was like, you know.
That was acceptable.
It was like
20
years ago.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But like, imagine that. Like, say, well, take advantage of the fucking online infrastructure that we have.
Yeah, and make that Pokemon
make
game. But yeah, I'm not hyped. You're kind of accepting it, but not hyped.
I'm accepting that because it's an inevitability. It's happening.
Oh yeah,
it's just it's either gonna bomb or. But right now, and like I say,
You just whispered, I do think it's going to bomb. And you probably didn't hear that. Yeah,
it is, though.
But, I mean,
it'll do well in Japan.
Yeah, and China.
A lot of kids will get it.
Will nag that, My kids won't. You hear that?
But it could be so much more. You know
what
I mean?
Yeah. So do the Pokemon game.
But so seriously, yeah. Like you said, though, that's the thing that they've got to do, though, is if they're not going to get the third-party publishers, is change their current games in meaningful ways.
Yeah, definitely.
Like, make Zelda, like, a co-op game.
Yeah.
Or online.
Do something new.
Yeah. Something, like, that really shakes it up.
Yeah, like the Pokemon game.
Switch it up.
Switch it up, you man.
Well, I think that's all for this edition of the Unashamed Gamers. Thanks for listening. And do stick around for the trailer for Where Next.
Yes, it's coming next.
It's awkward and everything.
Yeah, it's terrible. It's brilliantly terrible. But
as always, just remember that GG doesn't stand for a good game. It stands for
Get Good. Welcome to Bring It Gaming UK. I'm Paul. This is Ben.
Hello. Today we're going to be telling you about our new YouTube show, Where Next, where we're going to talk about a game or a game franchise and where we think it should go next. Yeah,
genius.
Crazy. It's as simple as that.
Yeah.
So, you know, if you're a fan of the podcast, and you know, you really wanted to see our faces, that's kind of what this show is. We're just going to be sitting down and talking because we're kind of
love sitting down
right,
and talking.
All right at that. I'm definitely good at sitting down
and talking
and talking about video games.
Yeah,
and just discussing, you know, where we think the series could go. Like, say, Assassin's Creed. You know, that's had a couple of years off. Where we think the next one could be?
Space.
Yeah, Templars in space.
I think that's brilliant.
It sounds like a Saints Row DLC.
I play it. You play it.
Yeah, I'd play that, to be fair. I love a bit of co-op.
Yeah.
But yeah, if that's something you'd be interested in, then do like, subscribe on YouTube. I don't know why I'm pointing down. There's usually links and stuff in it.
Yeah.
Click the link. There might be one. Who knows?
Link.
Depends where you watch this, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
On your phone. I don't know. Why am I still talking? Anyway, thanks for watching. What?
Just keep waving. They'll leave before we do.
How long is the left recording? Another hour?
Welcome to Bring It UK. Bring It UK. Bring It UK.